गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द प्रॉब्लम नंबर 12. सो क्वेश्चन, आई रेफर द क्वेश्चन पेपर 2018 फॉर 14 मार्क्स. हियर इज गिवन ओवरहेड कॉस्ट ऑफ सर्विस डिपार्टमेंट बिफोर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ प्रोडक्शन डिपार्टमेंट कॉस्ट आर एज फॉलोज. सो देर इज़ ए 3 प्रोडक्शन डिपार्टमेंट एंड 2 सर्विस डिपार्टमेंट. Here production department amount is given 7,550 from A department and B department 7,200 and C 9,650 and D 4,625 and E 1,575. The cost of service departments D and E are to be charged on the basis of following percentage. D and E is the service department. So you have to take the all the percentage. D in the D service department from the A department is 20% and B 30 and C 40% and E is 10%. And E from the production department A 40%, 20%, 30% from C and 10% from D. The total overheads of production department by using the following methods. How to need to calculate simultaneously equation method. Another one is repeated distribution method. So first let us start for the first simultaneously equation method. First method is simultaneously equation method. So let x denote total overhead cost of service department X. X means D, can be take D values. Again let y denote service of values E. Let the x denote total overhead cost of service department is D and y denote the total overhead cost of service department E. So now we have to take the values. Step 1. X is equal to total overhead service department cost. How much is this total overhead? So 4,625. Take it 4,625 plus. So D 10% of E. 10% of E. E means X. Y, E means Y values. So another one is Y is equal to total overhead cost 1575 plus here is 20% of D. 20% of D, D means X value. Is it clear? Let us x denote the D values and y denote the E values. So next step second. So we have to simplify this. X is equal to 4625 plus 10% with 0.1 y. Again y is equal to 1575 plus 20% means 20 divided by 100, that is 0.2 y. so this is the equation number 2. So next third step 3. step 3. So can we use one of the equations, whether you have to take x values, first we have to find out the x values, or we can be take y values. So now I will take x values. X is equal to 4625 plus 0.11. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂವನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡು ನೀವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಅಥವಾ ವೈ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂವನ್ನು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 4625 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 0.1 y. y means I will take these values. Y andre nilli 1575 plus 0.25. So that's why I took this. Bracket half beka compulsory. So here is 0.1 y means 1575 plus 0.2 y. Then you will take x is equal to 4625 plus 0.1 into 1575. Then it comes 157.5. So I will round it 158. Plus 0.1 into 0.2 one second. So here is y is equal to 1575 plus 20%. It is not a 10%, sorry, can they take 10%? So then it comes 0.1. so once again I will repeat, this is the 10%. So here is E, 10% of D. So 10% of Y. Another one is, so here is 10% of E, 10% of X. Okay. So then it comes, X is equal to 4625 plus 10% means 0.1%, and Y values 1575 plus 10% means 0.1. So can we take 0.1? So here is 0.1 into 1575, that is 158, that comes 157.5. I will round it here 158, and 0.1 into 0.1, then it comes 0.01 xy. Again we have to simplify this. So 4625 plus 158, it comes 4783 plus 0.011. Come this way. So here is x. X means 1x minus, so here is equal to 4783 plus 0.01. so right hand side we have to take the left hand side, that is x means 1x. So we have to take left hand side, then it comes minus 0.011 is equal to 4783. Then the value is 1x minus 0.01 means it comes 0.99x is equal to 4783. Then we need to calculate the x values is equal to 4783 divided by 0.99. So then the values is x is equal to 4831. Is it clear? So now we have to get the x values. So now we have to got the x values. Then next step, step 4, we need to apply the second equation. So now we have to find out the y values. So y is equal to 1575 plus 10% means 0.1 into x. How much is the x value? 4831. So now can be easily find out the y values. 1575 plus 0.1 into 4831. It comes 483. So then the y values is 2058. Is it clear? So can be easily calculate the x as well as the y values. So now we have to find out the statement showing the simultaneously equation method. Let's start the simultaneously equation method. There is a three production department A, B, C. The values is as per the primary distribution 7550, write it here. Then the second values is 7200 and third values is 9650. So next very important step, you can be reapportion to the all the production department from the service department. Your service department first number 1 D. So how much is the value? D values is, D means x values 4831. So we have to distributed to the all three production department on the given ratio 20 is to D department 20 is to 30 is to 40, that is 20% 30% and 40% 20% and 30% and 40%. So can be distributed to the 4831 into 20%, then it comes 9660. Next 1450. Next 1932. Then service department E. Service department E, the value of service department E is 2058 in the given ratio. So that is 40 20 30, write it here. 40% 20% and last one is 30%, or you can be take the ratios. So take it your values. So 2058 can be distributed to the all the department, that is it come 823 412 617. So now the total of all the department 9339. Next 9062, then 12199. Is it clear? So this is for the simultaneously equation method. So next one is repeated equation method. Second one is repeated equation method. Then you have to take this second method. So this is for the repeated distribution method. There is a three production department and two service department. Service department is D and E. So first we have to write the overhead as per the primary distribution. So that is, so write it all the overhead as per the primary distribution. Next step, we will take the service department, department D. So much is the service department due? 4625 minus 4625. We will reapportion to the all the three production department and each service department in the given ratios or the percentage. So here is percentage 20, 30, 40 and 10. 2 is to 3 is to 4 is to 1 or you can be take directly on the percentage. So 20, 30, 40, 10%. Write it. Take the ratios. Percentage 4625 into 20%, 30%, 40% and 10%. Then it comes 925, then 1387.5 and 1850 and 462.5. Then, so can be now the department D is nil. Then take the department E, so that is minus 462.5, or you can be rounded this. Take the total 1575 plus 462.5, then it comes 2037.5. So minus 2037.5 then the values it comes 815 then 407.5 or 611.25 and 203.75. Then, so now E value is nil, service department E is nil. Then take the service department D, the value is minus 203.75. So take the values, then the department D, here is department D. So minus means 203.75 distributed to the all the production department, then it comes 40.75, then 61.12 and 81.5 and last column is 20.38. So now the D column is nil. Then the to take the E column's value here minus E values, take ratios E values, then you have to distribute it to 20.38 into 40%. It comes 8.15. Then 6.12, then 6.11. Value is, so here the value 2.38. So then it comes value is next and last one is minus 2.38. So nearest 10, so I have to take for the E values, so then it comes 1 and 1, so that can be rounded 2.38. 38, it is close to the 3, so can be taken the nil values. Here also nil. Then finally get the total. So in the first column 9,339.9. Here is 9,339, correct, 0.9. Next, second one is 9,062 and another one is 12,199. So same value, approximately same. So some little bit points have been changes on there. So next here nil and e value is nil. So both are the nil. Is it clear? So I hope you can understand for this method. So this is for the approximately, simultaneously and repeated methods output is approximately same. Thank you.